Namaste. Welcome to yet another week of yoga practice. This week we have somebody very interesting to share his knowledge and his skills as a trainer. With us is Vivek Tiwari. Sri Vivek Tiwari is exceptional because he has such experience in the training of yoga. He's been trained by the Kaivalya Dham Yoga Institute. 24 years of experience back him up. He has been recently deputed to conduct workshops by the Government of India as a yoga trainer at the Consulate General of India in St. Petersburg, Russia. Recognized and appreciated for his outstanding work in the field of yoga and Indian culture, with specific focus on the therapeutical, anatomical, and scientific aspects of yoga. Vivek Tiwari ji is also a Pilates instructor. Let's join him this week as he takes us through several different aspects of yoga. We hope you enjoy this program. So let's get on the mat and start our practice. Namaste.
Namaste, this is Vivek Tiwari from Kaivalya Dham Yoga Institute, Lonavala. I welcome you all to enjoy these progressive yoga sessions. Out of them, this is the first session, which is the pre-yogic practices. So, as per the tradition of Kaivalya Dham, we are going to start with prayer. So, I request all of you to sit comfortable and straight. Eyes are gently closed. And hands in Namaskar Mudra. Those who don't know the prayer is displayed on the screen. You can read the prayer. Slowly inhale. Om Sahana Vavatu Sahanau Bhunaktu Sahaviryam karavavahai tejasvina vadhitamastu ma vidvishavahai om shanti shanti shantihi. Slowly release your hands and you can open your eyes. So, the pre-yogic practices that is going to help you to improve the microcirculation, blood circulation in small joints. It will give stretch to your particular muscles, small muscles, core muscles. And apart from that, you are going to get ready for the pre-yogic or traditional yoga practices through those pre-yogic exercises or pre-yogic practices, or it is called as Sukshma Vyayam. We have Swarup with us. He is going to demonstrate all those practices. So I welcome Swarup and we'll start with some pre-yogic practices. Now the question is, how to remember the sequence of those practices and how they are going to help us in which kinds of problems or diseases this will be helpful for us. This is going to help each and everybody having any problem, any disease like heart problems, high blood pressure, diabetes, joint pain, arthritis, or muscular pain, body pain, those who are not able to sit on the ground. Each and everybody can practice this, even those who don't have any problem. For them, only for the preparation, only to improve the circulation or to warm up yourself, this is going to help you. Okay, so we don't have any restriction, any limitation or any contraindication to those practices. I taught thousands of people and cured them from various diseases through those practices. So we are, and the sequence is very simple. You know, we are going to start with the fingers, palms, wrist, elbow, shoulder, then neck. Then in the same way, we'll start from the toes, feet, ankle joint, knee joint, hip joint, and then the spine. This is the simple sequence of the practice. So let us start with our fingers and palms. So first, you are stretching your hands in front of you at the shoulder level. Palms are facing down. Then you are going to stretch your fingers, spread them fully, and then closing the fist very slowly with the full strength, and again slowly open them. In this way, you are going to open the fingers and close the fist. Stretch the fingers and close the fist. 4 to 5 times, 6 to 8 times, 8 to 10 times. So as per the time availability, you can practice it, you can repeat it. Okay, this is going to give exercise and circulation, going to improve microcirculation in your fingers. After 4 to 5 times, you'll release your hands. Now take your hands down. Again, I will ask you to lift your hands, again take them down, because we are not habitual to hang our hands or hold our hands at the shoulder for a long time, and this will be painful for you. Okay, so that is why again and again you can take rest for some time. Now again take your hands at the shoulder level, then stretch your fingers, fold at the elbows, and tip of the fingers are coming on each other like this. Imagine you are holding a big ball or a baseball in your fingers, in your palms like this. Spreading the elbows out, shoulders are relaxed. And now as per your strength, your capacity, you are going to press your tip of the fingers on each other and then release the pressure. Again, press them and release the pressure. In this way, you will repeat again 4 to 5 times or 6 to 8 times. This is very good for arthritis, joint pain, those who are having rheumatoid arthritis, for them, because arthritis starts from the fingers, from the small joints. So this is going to improve the blood circulation and you won't have any problem or pain in the beginning after having the problem. Or those who are having the problems like arthritis, they will increase the pain in the beginning, but you have to practice it, you'll have to bear some pain in the beginning. Now after this repetition, now you are keeping your palms on each other like this, spreading the fingers. Okay, fingers are pointed up, elbows are spreading out, and then again you are pressing your palms on each other as much as you can, and then release the pressure. Again, press them on each other, and if it is possible to take your palms little down, so that you'll get stretch in your wrists also. And again release it. Again pressing and taking your palms down, but your root of the palms should remain together. This should not happen like this. Okay, your palms should remain together. That much only you have to take them down, and again release it. In this way, 4 to 5 times you'll repeat. You'll feel the pressure and you'll feel the stretch and effect in your shoulder joint, in your elbow, and in your wrist also from here. After finishing this, again take your hands down, relax for some time. After this one, now you are going to come to the we'll come to the wrist again, hands at the shoulder level, fingers together. Then you are going to move your palms alternately, one palm going up, one palm going down, like this, from the wrist movement, like this. Elbows will remain straight, hands are absolutely stable, and movement will happen from the wrist only. A mindful movement or yogic movement, you know. So that should not be very fast like this. It should be very controlled movement, and you have to pay attention on each and every moment so that you'll feel the changes and effects of the practice. So that internal or minute changes you have to feel with each moment. After few repetitions, now again you'll keep your palms here as it is, and then you are going to take them sidewards and inward like this. You are taking them out from the wrist joint and then taking them in this way. This kind of movement happens very rarely in our wrist joint. You'll repeat this movement again 4 to 5 times, 6 to 8 times, depending on the time available or depending on the problems you have, that you'll decide that how many times I have to repeat this. Keep your hands stable and elbows straight. After those repetitions, now you are going to rotate them like this. Again, try to keep your elbows straight, hands absolutely stable, and maximum range of movement from the wrist joints, wrist rotation. This is with the open fingers. After this, we are going to do it with the closed fists also. Then opposite direction. After 4 to 5 repetitions, release. Please stop the movement and take your hands down, relax for some time. So we practiced with the fingers, palms, and then wrist. Again, we are going to repeat some more practices for the wrist only. Hands at the shoulder level. This time you are going to close the fists. And with closed fists, you are going to rotate it. You'll feel the difference when your palms are straight, your fingers are straight, and then when you are closing the fist and rotating your wrist, you'll feel the difference. You are giving movement in your wrist, but the effect you'll feel in your elbow joint, in your shoulder joint also. In opposite direction. Remember, there is a big difference in physical exercise and yoga practice. So we always say yoga practice, not yogic exercise. Yoga exercise, there is no relation of yoga and exercise. That is why we should say yoga practice, not yoga exercise. Physical exercise, yoga practice. So that is why these are yogic, pre-yogic practices. After few repetitions, again, you'll release and relax for some time. Give rest to your hands. You know, because of our luxurious life, we are not habitual to lift our hands or to maintain our hands at the shoulder level, and then it is painful. So that is why it is painful in the beginning. But when you'll be habitual to maintain your hands at the shoulder level for longer time, that means you are healthy if you don't have pain and you are able to hold the hands. Now again, hands at the shoulder level in front of you. This time your palms are up like this. Okay. Now from here, after the wrist, you are going to give practice to your elbow joint. So for the elbows, you are going to fold your elbows, flex the elbows, and again open them in front of you. But imagine you have 2 pounds weight in each hand, and with that weight, that means you have to activate your biceps, and with the activated biceps, you have to fold the elbows and again extend them. While folding the elbows, you can close the fist, and while extending the hand, you are extending the fingers in this way. But while bending, it should not drop down. Okay, elbows will remain here at the shoulder level in this way. After a few repetitions, you'll release and relax. Now for the elbows only, we have one more, that is twisting of the elbow. So you are maintaining your hands close to the torso, elbows are bending at 90 degree, close the fist, and then you are turning your palms, wrists out and in. So when your hands are at the shoulder level, that time the twisting will happen from the shoulder joint also. Here we want twisting from the elbow and wrist only. So that is why this one, in this way, in and out, bending the elbow, elbows are close, and then in this way, not rotation, twisting in and twisting out, rotating in and rotating out. Release. After this, now coming to the shoulder joint. After elbow joint, now coming to the shoulder joint. Hands at the shoulder level in front of you. Close the fist. And then you are going to twist your hands out and in. Outer rotation and inward rotation. In this way. Okay, after 5 to 6 repetitions, you'll stop. Again, hands at the shoulder level, fist closed. You are going to again turn your hands out and in, rotate them in and out like this, as it is. And with the rotation, keep rotating in and out. And then with the twisting moment, you are stretching your hands at the shoulder level by the sides. Taking your hands at the shoulder level by the sides. Then take them overhead slowly with the moment. Then slowly take them down. Those who are having frozen shoulder, shoulder pain, cervical problems, for them this will help a lot. In the beginning it will be painful, of course, but after the practice of 1 week, you'll be very comfortable with this. Again, we are going to give some practices to the shoulders only. This time you are placing your fingers on respect to shoulders, bending at the elbows. Your both the upper arms and elbows are at the shoulder level, and then around the axis of the shoulder, very small range of movement, you are going to rotate your shoulders in this way. 5 to 6 times in forward direction, and then 5 to 6 times in reverse direction, opposite direction, in this way. This small range of movement is more challenging. It improves your body-mind coordination, and the core muscles of the this rotator cuff, so that rotator cuff muscles are getting activated, getting strengthened. And after this small range of movement, now you are going to give full range of movement. In full range of movement, it will include your scapula also, not only shoulder joint, but the shoulder blades. In this way, elbows should come close to each other in front of the chest. Then from close to the torso, you are opening it out backward, then going up by the sides of the head, and then again in front of the face like this, in this very slow speed and maximum range of movement. Again 4 to 5 times in forward direction and then 4 to 5 times in reverse direction, opposite direction. These are very simple practices that you are going to practice sitting on the chair. So this is our tendency. Always we make the reasons that I have no time, I am very busy, I am not able to sit on the ground, I am not able to perform any exercise, this, that. So instead of making the reasons, it is better to find the solution. And this is the solution, that by sitting on the chair, on your sofa set, in your car, while traveling, in a flight, anywhere, you can practice those things. No reason, not making the reasons. So this is the solution to practice anywhere. Even you can practice it in your office while working also. Doesn't matter. After forward and reverse movement, now release and relax. So this is up to shoulder level, from the fingers, palms, wrist, elbow and shoulder and scapulae, as you have covered up. Now we are going to give some movements to your neck and scapulae again. So for the upper back and scapulae, we have different movements in our scapulae, our shoulder blades, that is elevation and then depression. So elevate your scapulae, your shoulders, lifting them up, and then depressing them down like this. Again, for the cervical spondylitis or any kind of neck pain, shoulder pain, this is going to help a lot. There are so many people that they cured themselves by practicing those things. Now, protraction and retraction. Shoulder blades, scapulae going away from each other. Shoulders are rounded forward here. Then scapulae coming close to each other, widening at the collarbone like this. This one. Protraction and this is retraction. Because your scapulae are just floating with the help of the surrounding muscle. They don't have bony attachment. That is why there is a chance of having pain or having any problem in the scapulae or the shoulders. So to protect yourself from the injuries, it is necessary to strengthen the surrounding muscles. And that is why such kinds of practices will stabilize your scapulae properly. Now rotation. Backward rotation of the shoulders and scapulae in this way. This should happen very easily when it is tensed. So after this shoulder rotation, now we are coming to the neck. So for the neck, we have a practice of Brahma Mudra, in which very slowly you are going to turn your face to your right side. To turn your face in one direction, you should take more than 10 seconds. And then again come in center in 10 seconds. Then you are turning your face towards the left side in this way, again coming in center. Then face up, center. Then face down, chin to the jugular notch, again center, then dropping your head to the side, ear to the shoulder like this, but not shoulder to the ear, so shoulder is relaxed. Again center, and then to the left side. So those six movements, which are the basic six movements in our spine, those six movements you are giving to the neck. Now coming to the legs, we'll start with the toes. So your feet are together, make sure your feet are flat on the ground in the beginning. Then you are taking your legs little further so that your heels are on the ground. Then you are stretching your toes and then squeezing them like this. So the movement of the toes. So remember, this is happening only in the toes, not in your ankle joint. The next movement will be in the ankle joint. After the toes, then you are going to stretch your legs in front and then move your feet from the ankle joints. Point and flex your feet. That is known as dorsiflexion and plantar flexion. This one. After a few repetitions of your ankle joints and toes, then you are going to rotate them. Inward rotation and outward rotation of the ankle joints. Those who are having leg pain, knee problems, osteoarthritis, knee pain, for them, such kinds of practices will help a lot. This will be beneficial for you. Even those who are having swelling in the legs, varicose veins, for them also, this is going to help. Now, again, you are resting your heels on the ground, knees and legs are together. Now, for the knees, you are going to extend your legs straight, coming parallel to the ground, and then again bend at the knees. So, you have to use your quadriceps, front thighs, to pull the kneecaps and extend the legs at the knees. This is the best exercise for knee problems. Knee pain. After a few repetitions of this knee exercise or knee movement, now we are going to give movement to ankle joint, knee joint and hip joint together. For that, you are going to give the paddling movement. With your right leg in forward direction, you are going to rotate the leg in paddling movement. So this paddling movement is giving exercise to your hip joint, knee joint and ankle joint, all the three joints together. Those who are having leg pain, swelling in the legs, varicose veins, for them this is very beneficial. Then in reverse order, try to cover up the biggest circle with the slow speed. And after the practice, day by day, you can increase the repetitions also. Now with the left leg in the same way, in forward direction 3 to 4 times, reverse direction 3 to 4 times. Because of some particular problems, like if you have hip replacement or very painful, if it is very painful, then you can practice it in lying down position also. After forward and reverse direction with the left leg, again feet resting on the ground, sitting straight. Now remaining is your spine. For the spine, as I told you, there are six basic movements in the spine. So for the spine, you are going to give the twist. For that, you are going to twist to your right side. Then your right hand goes behind the backrest and you are holding your right hand rest with the left hand. And then twist as much as you can. Come back. In the same way, you are going to twist to your left side. So this is giving a benefit of Vakrasana or Ardhamatsyendrasana or Katichakrasana, sitting on the chair. Especially those twisting asanas and side bending practices, come back slowly. These are very helpful for spinal problems, back pain, good for diabetes, good for digestion. Now we are going for the side stretching. For that, you are holding the right armrest with the left hand in this way, crossing it, opposite armrest, and then you are stretching your hand towards the ceiling and then bending to the side, so that will give stretch to your right side of the torso. Keep your face in front, do not drop or rotate downward, slowly come up. And then change with the other side. This side you'll get stretched to the left side of the torso. So mostly all the twisting asanas, side bending asanas are very helpful for the spinal problems. Especially this side bending is very good for scoliosis. Come back. And now two more moments are remaining, that is backward stretch. So you are going to stretch yourself backward, giving backward stretch to the spine, looking up. You can hold your armrest of the chair, release, and in the same way from the upper thoracic you are going to stretch forward, forward stretch. And release in this way. So these are the few pre-yogic exercises or pre-yogic practices that will open up your joints, that will improve the microcirculation and blood circulation, so that your body and mind will be ready without any pain, without any problem, without any lethargy to practice the traditional asanas very easily without any pain. So I hope that you are enjoying the session, and hope to see you in the next series of the session. Now we'll conclude the session with the Shanti part. So hands in Namaskar Mudra, eyes gently closed. Slowly inhale. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Now we are going towards meditation.
Welcome to Heartfulness Meditation. Please approach this meditation with an attitude of openness to fresh experience. Heartfulness Meditation is aided by a very subtle transformative energy called pranahuti or transmission. Choose a place where you can meditate without being distracted. Turn off your phone or any device that may disturb you. Make sure you're sitting comfortably. You can sit cross-legged or in a chair. Let your hands rest in your lap, loosely clasped. Let your eyes be closed gently. Let your back be upright, but not rigid. Feel free to change your posture during meditation if you feel uncomfortable. We will begin with the simple practice of heartfulness relaxation. Once you feel relaxed, you will be guided into the heartfulness meditation. We will all meditate together in silence, so we may feel the peace that surfaces when we turn our attention inward and dive deep into our hearts. Through the heart, we find unity. Through the heart, we create a feeling of well-being. First, relax. Close your eyes very gently, very softly. We will begin with our toes. Move your toes. Relax them. Imagine the soothing, healing energy from the earth moving up into your feet, slowly relaxing them. Feel it relax your toes, the soles of your feet, your ankles. As this energy moves upwards, relax your calves, relax your knees. Feel it relax each and every muscle in your thighs deeply. Feel both your legs becoming totally relaxed. Relax your stomach, your waist, your hips. Let go of any tension or stress you may be holding there. And relax. Allow your back to soften. From your tailbone to your shoulders, feel your entire back relaxing. Relax your chest. Relax your shoulders. Let this healing energy from the earth melt away any tension or stress you may be holding on your shoulders. Feel your shoulders melt away and relax. As this energy moves down your arms, relax them. Feel it relax your upper arms, your elbows, your forearms, your wrists, your hands. Let the energy flow out of your fingertips, leaving both your arms deeply relaxed. Relax all the muscles in your neck. Bring your awareness to your face and relax it. Feel the healing energy from the earth. Relax your jaws, your mouth, your lips. Feel your ears relax. Breathe normally. Relax your nose. Keep your eyes softly closed. Relax them. Relax your forehead. Feel all the tension, stress, and anxiety there simply melt away. As this healing energy from the earth moves further upwards, relax your entire head all the way to the base of your skull. Feel now how your whole body is totally relaxed. Take a moment, scan your system from top to toe. And if there is any part of your body that is still tense, painful, or unwell, feel it being immersed in the healing energy of the earth for a little while longer. When you're ready, move your attention to your heart. Rest there for a little while. Feel immersed in the love and light in your heart. Now, we will meditate together. Make a suggestion that the source of divine light that is already present inside your heart is attracting your attention towards it. Gently relax into that feeling. Let it be a very light suggestion, without force or concentration. If you find your awareness drifting to other thoughts, do not fight them, but also do not entertain them. Let them be like clouds passing in the sky. Gently remind yourself that you're meditating on the source of divine light in your heart. Be open and receptive to the transmission that will be flowing into you. Allow your awareness to melt into your heart. Remain absorbed within your heart until you hear the meditation has ended. Please start meditation. That's all. Keep your eyes closed for a little while longer and tune in to how you feel. Absorb all the peace that you have experienced. Now, imagine that this peace is expanding outward to everyone, uniting everything around you, and is encircling the world. When you open your eyes, take the time to enjoy the experience. You can write your experience in a journal. It will help you to develop awareness and observation. We thank you for expanding this feeling of peace, unity, and well-being around the world.